got very late notice that their trips have been canceled. Care 11's John Cronin brings the story of a Maple Grove family that traveled a long way for nothing.
The children in the Westburg household of Maple Grove are a pretty plugged-in bunch. So this year, their parents decided to dispense with the traditional Christmas presents and instead give them a cruise to the sunny Caribbean.
We actually were supposed to be on Stingray Beach in Cozumel right now as we speak.
They were booked on this Monday's excursion of the ill-fated Carnival Triumph, which was still right on schedule when the family of eight packed into that Odyssey minivan in the wee hours Sunday morning and started the long drive to Galveston, Texas.
And flying out of Minneapolis and going to Houston was going to cost us about $7,000. We decided that, heck, we can take a road trip, put everyone in the car, and kind of make, you know, have some fun with it.
They had almost reached Texas when Jessica got Carnival's first email alert Sunday afternoon saying their cruise might be shortened because of the Triumph's engine room fire. But a customer service rep put her mind at ease.
He heard a rumor that the Carnival Magic was going to be picking us up from Galveston, and he told me that we for sure would be on a cruise.
5 hours later, a second urgent email from Carnival said the cruise had been canceled.
She started crying, and she said, I'm really sorry, guys, but the cruise was canceled.
By then, the Westbergs were well into Texas, so a stop at the Dallas Zoo became their long-awaited Christmas present. Carnival did offer to rebook them on a cruise this summer, but for $2,000 more.
My thought is, if there was something wrong with your product, then you should exchange it for something else. And it didn't seem right that we would have to pay more money to get on a different cruise.
In Maple Grove, John Cronin, Care 11 News.
Well, if you've gone on a cruise recently, what was that experience?